Back in the Premier League and having an impact, Chelsea gets the win, Arsenal another defeat. Tim Howard, let's start here. Biggest takeaway from this match for you?
Oh, one would, well, I have two. Sorry, Liam. I think Lukaku was fantastic. I think he demands the ball every time. He's a traditional number nine. He leads that line. He causes fear in the back line. And then he loves his teammates. You see the hugs and the praise that they give him and he gives them. So Lukaku, brilliant. But Arsenal, tactically, we're expecting Mikel Arteta certainly to get it right from the beginning because he knows how Chelsea's going to play. It's no secret. And then at halftime, no problem. Change something up. We didn't see that. And so, yeah, Arsenal is a worry for me.
This is a new concern with Arsenal. They had concerns before and there were pressures, but just the idea of maybe being unprepared in this situation?
Yeah, I think in terms of tactically, I think we all assume that he's a very bright coach, a thinker, he's off the back of Pep, a Man City and his experiences. He comes across as that sort of guy. But if you didn't know who he was, and everybody in the football world looked at that Arsenal first half performance where they got kind of really stretched out and the right side was totally open for Chelsea, you'd be like, wow, who is this guy? It's almost like naive coaching, I want to say. And on the back of that, the thought that they could be open and expansive and throwing people forward and allow them to stay forward in an open game of football against a team as good as Chelsea, again, really? So I agree. It's kind of like that was a really surprising edge to this game.
Let me ask this. Does pride play a factor? Sometimes if you think you have the best team, you go toe-to-toe and you say, to heck with your tactics.
He must know he hasn't got the best team.
I agree with you. So that's my point. I'm saying, does pride then come in? Does he say, I think...
Home game, first game, we're Arsenal.
Not changing.
We're going to go forward. Yeah, maybe.
But essentially, at that point, you're questioning his judgment in terms of knowing how good his team is.
Yeah.
Right? Because if you think they're that good.
Yeah, I mean, to play open against that Chelsea team is incredibly risky, and that's where the game was lost in the first half.
Yep, there was risk. It backfired for them. Chelsea got the win, and we go back to the Emirates, bringing the gents to call the match for us, Arlo, Graham, and Lee. Gentlemen, get your final thoughts on this one.
Thanks, Liam. I'll go to you first, Lee. Arsenal defeated again, second time in 2 weeks. Assess Mikel Arteta's performance as coach today.
Well, it's quite easy to blame the players all the time, and I think the manager has to take some responsibility with today's defeat. We saw a different match-up in systems, and when that happens, as Graham pointed out in commentary, you get pluses and minuses in both systems. Chelsea's pluses were bigger than Arsenal's, and they didn't work the problem out. It was so obvious down that right-hand side for Chelsea with Reece James and Mason Mount that they were overloading that left side of the Arsenal defence. So sort it out. The goal came from there. Two or three chances came from there. And in the end, I kept looking down. What's he going to do? How is he going to change it? Sometimes you change it on the pitch as players. You take control of that. Arsenal don't have that type of leaders on the pitch to be able to do that. So you have to look over at the sideline and say, what are we going to do? OK, we'll change it at half-time. They didn't. They came back out. They played a bit better, as Robbie said. But ultimately, tactically, they lost. Forget about the man-to-man and how good Chelsea were. They lost that game tactically today, and that is the manager's fault.
How impressed, on the flip side, were you with Thomas Tuchel's Chelsea?
Yeah, very good. I mean, you know what you're going to get from Chelsea. Since the day he took charge of the club, he stamped an identity on that group of players, and there's competition for places. Every player looks totally comfortable and at ease in their position. They help each other out. They link. They've got a good balance. They're in perfect shape at the moment. They took Arsenal apart in the first half. And as I said, they played well within themselves in the second half, but always looked a threat. And Lukaku, as Tim and Robbie were saying, you know, he's the absolute perfect fit for them up front. He's going to do really well this season.
Could he be the difference in terms of winning the title?
He's certainly given every opportunity to be up there. I think they'll be right up there with Man City, with Man United. And Liverpool, I think it's a four-horse race. There's no doubt about that. And at the moment, they look very strong. Long way to go. As far as Arsenal concerned, you go, the way they're going at the moment, you know, eighth is kind of, we'll take that.
OK. The first Lasso-Dixon derby of the season goes the way of Graham Lasso's former club, Chelsea.
Well, he didn't win one when he was a player, so he might as well win.
Lee can have the last word.
How comprehensive a victory was that for Chelsea?
What is comprehensive?
Totally in control.
Maybe I didn't feel us in. Yeah, I had the feeling in first half we lack a bit of sharpness and of activity. We got in some moments a bit passive. I think we had a long training week and we trained very, very hard, double sessions. So I had the feeling we were a bit leggy. Second half we overcame like the some minutes in the beginning, and then it was, and then we controlled it very, very good, created some chances. I think we deserve to win, but still room to improve.